Ladymatic presents Leading Women.
It's nearly 8 p.m. at the Seoul Arts Center, and the crowd is streaming in. Thousands of music lovers here to see one of South Korea's most famous artists. As the orchestra tunes and the conductor takes the podium, the anticipation builds until she steps on stage. This is what they've come for. She's an award-winning opera diva who's performed at some of the most renowned performance halls in the world, the Metropolitan Opera in New York, La Scala in Milan, and she has more than 50 recordings to her credit. This world-class soprano is Sumi Jo. Sumi Jo's fame is rooted in an opera career that's lasted more than 25 years and performances all over the world.
I open my mouth, I start to sing. I can realize that they just, they got a beautiful smile on their face. I can see them from the stage. So I say, wow, this is beautiful. I can do something special for them, you know? I think that's the best part of my life.
Known for her mastery of elaborate roles from Italian opera, like Gilda in Rigoletto and Lucia in Lucia de Lammermoor.
All these women, at the end, you die for love, and you know, those dramatic roles I prefer. But recently I discovered that I'm quite good as in comic roles as well.
Jo is still a big star in her home country, though she hasn't lived in Seoul since moving to Rome nearly three decades ago. This morning, she's getting ready for an interview on television station MBN, asked to share her thoughts on everything from the upcoming Korean presidential election to the country's rise as a global trendsetter.
문화적으로 또 그 곳 사람들과 이렇게 교통을 한다는 거는 그 생각하시는 것보다도 훨씬 더 그 시너지가 큰 것 같아요.
Later, it's off to rehearsal.
Tonight is going to be a rehearsal with the orchestra.
She takes a few minutes to check in with her dog sitter in Rome.
Sì, tutto bene, come sta? Millie, Tommy, Cindy.
Yes, really. And to call her mother, who she has yet to see in Seoul.
네, 엄마? 네, 저예요.
For a public figure, Joe is startlingly honest about the toll she feels her career has taken on her personal life. With constant travel and concert tours and recording commitments, she rarely sees her family and has never married.
Sometimes I feel very lonely and sad. I mean, I think everybody sometimes feels alone, but especially in this job, it's not easy. It's because I'm a home person. I love to be at home. I love cooking, I love cleaning, I love shopping, you know, those things.
Her toughest moment came in 2006, when her father died. She was due to perform in Paris, and her mother urged to sing for her audience instead of returning home for the funeral. She broke down in tears during the encore, Schubert's Ave Maria.
It was an incredible, the most saddest moment in my life. And I announced to the audience to say that, you know, my situation. And everybody stood up and applauded.
At tonight's rehearsal, she'll practice a lesser-known version of Ave Maria, this one by Italian composer Caccini. Along with one of the crossover songs in her repertoire.
I think I'm more me when I'm performing alone, like recitals and concerts, because I can wear different dresses and then I can be you know, direct with the audience. It's just more fun for me.
In the coming weeks, see how she feels about her image as an opera diva.
OMEGA Ladymatic presents Leading Women.